Students, our next topic is Kirchhoff's rules. In simple electrical circuits, the resistance and potential difference are calculated using Ohm's law, V is equal to IR. But in actual practice, we come across complicated electrical circuits which contain large number of resistors and sources of EMF. The simple application of Ohm's law, this failed to solve these complicated electrical circuits. Therefore, to solve these complicated electrical circuits, Kirchhoff gave two rules. These are called Kirchhoff's rules. Two terms are used in Kirchhoff rules, junction or node and loop or mesh. We will define these. Now the junction. Junction is a point in the electrical circuit where two or more conductors are connected electrically. This is junction. Junction is a point where two or more conductors are connected electrically. Junction is also called node. Junction or node. Loop or mesh. Loop or mesh is a closed path in an electrical circuit. It is a closed path in a electrical circuit. Now, Kirchhoff's first rule. According to Kirchhoff's first rule, the algebraic sum of various currents meeting at a junction in a closed electrical circuit is always zero. Summation I is equal to zero. That is the algebraic sum of various currents meeting at a junction in a closed electrical circuit is always zero. A sign convention is followed. The sign convention is the current flowing towards the junction, they are taken as positive, and current flowing away from the junction are taken as negative. Let us understand Kirchhoff's first rule with the help of example. For example, in this figure, O is a junction. In an electrical circuit, O is a junction in an electrical circuit where five conductors carrying current I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5, they are meeting. O is a junction in an electrical circuit where five conductors carrying current I1, I2, I3, I4 and I5 are meeting. According to Kirchhoff's first rule, current flowing toward the junction is taken as positive. Therefore, I1 is positive. Plus current flowing away from the junction is taken as negative. Therefore, this will be plus minus I2. I3 is flowing away from the, therefore plus minus I3. I4 is flowing toward the junction. Therefore, this is plus I4. I5 is flowing away from the, this. Therefore, this is plus minus I5. Therefore, we can write this as I1 plus minus minus. I1 minus I2 minus I3 plus I4 minus I5 is equal to 0. Taking positives on the same side. Therefore, I1 plus I4. Taking negative on the other side, this become plus I2 plus I3 plus I5 taking on the right hand side. Therefore, I1 plus I4 is the total current flowing toward the junction. I2 plus I3 plus I5 is total current flowing away from the junction. Therefore, we can also say that according to Kirchhoff's first rule, total current flowing toward the junction is equal to total current flowing away from the junction. Therefore, the Kirchhoff first rule is also called Kirchhoff current rule or Kirchhoff junction rule. Kirchhoff first rule also applies to a point on a conductor. Therefore, total current flowing towards the point is equal to total current flowing away from the point. Kirchhoff first rule can also apply to a point on a conductor. Therefore, total current flowing toward the point is equal to total current flowing away from the point. This rule, Kirchhoff's first rule, supports the law of conservation of charge.